Hello and welcome, welcome, welcome. It is In Town, and I am your host, Jeff Decker, with another bunch of great things going on in the area. Thought I'd pump you up. It was a long trip today, but we made it here. The Knockmore outing, we got a lot to talk about, okay? Let's start off with tomorrow night's the wine tasting, the uncorked event at the Oakland County Market. Make sure you come out to that tomorrow night, 7 till 10. Should be a lot of fun. Marie and the gang from the Waterford Chamber put on such a great event, and also the gang, Desiree, and her help from the Oakland County Parks Division. They do a fabulous job out there. Come out, support the area, head out to the Farmers Market. What a great place. Wonderful event, great venue. Stop by. I'll see you tomorrow at Uncorked, okay? Stop by and say hi. We'll actually be there. Waterford Kettering is holding their version of Annie. That's right, the play Annie at Waterford Kettering through the 3rd and the 5th, through 3 through 5 of August here. Stop and see what fabulous theaters Waterford now has. I was at a production last year at Kettering. My goodness, you don't get better theaters. Just beautiful seats, fabulous accommodations, wonderful audio. Check out Annie. Then another great theater group is the Starlight Theater Group, and they've got Madagascar, the 3rd through the 6th. Then they're going to have August 18th through 22nd, Neil Simon's Barefoot in the Park. Now, if you haven't seen Barefoot in the Park, definitely, I mean, if you remember it with Robert Redford and Jane Fonda, what a great movie that was, fabulous play. Make sure you check it out. Support local theater, right? Tuesday night. So Tuesday night I head out, and thank you, Donna. It was a great time. We go to Pine Knob for Sir Rod. And he actually shows in the his knighting from the Prince of Wales. He gets knighted. It is Sir Rod Stewart now. And here's a little clip of Tuesday night. That's Rod. I mean, what a fabulous night. And okay, so I'm going to school here at Waterford, 400 years ago. And we actually went to Olympia, and I saw Rod Stewart with the Faces. Yeah. Yes, he is that old. He's that old, and so am I. Fabulous concert. Rod was in good voice. I've since gone to 3 other Rod Stewart concerts. He's blown his voice out every time. Ask Mike Konowski. We went and went, well, we're here, we're not going to take the refund. He had backup singers. He was still on stage and still kicks a lot of soccer balls up. What I'm going to do is I'm going to save a lot of these clips from these past 2 concerts. Rod Stewart, the other night, Tuesday, and Donna, that was a fabulous time. I'm looking forward to more concerts. We'll do that again. What a great night, and he was in fabulous voice. Then last night, Cork Bateman, my buddy Cork, and I went and saw Roger Waters. Now, we were expecting Roger Waters, Pink Floyd, the bass player. It's fabulous stuff, right? And here's a little sample of Roger Waters.
This is about Sid. Thank you.
So you think you can tell heaven from hell, right? Blue skies from hell. So Roger was great the first half. Cork wasn't that fabulous. Cork Bateman and I had a great time there until he takes a break. And then he comes back for the second half of the show. The second half of the show. I'm looking for Pink Floyd. What does Roger present me with? I don't go to concerts to get your political advice, thought pattern at all. I really don't. But I will take them when I'm looking for political commentary. But I don't pay $125 a seat to listen to Pink Floyd, or a few years ago with JH, we went and saw U2. And Bono wanted to talk about apartheid and how we should all in Michigan and everybody there give money. You guys are multi-billionaires. You're doing just fine. If you really want to support some kind of a thing, use your money, do it, but not on my time while I'm there to listen to music. I'm there to listen to music and have a good night. I don't need your political rhetoric at those times. I don't know anybody that does. And I don't care which way you feel about he is our president. Okay, there are bad things, yes. I'm glad, though, to get rid of the politics as usual. Yes, yes, there's bad things. But get rid of politics as usual. Yeah, he's done that, but I know. He's gone overboard in many, I know. But I didn't go to a concert to hear about this. And how about this? I didn't go there to hear about it from some Englishman who doesn't even live in the United States. I don't need your BS. I really don't. And nobody there did. I needed Pink Floyd songs. You gave me a good opening half, the second half with opening, some unbelievable lighting and audio and then we finally get the last couple of songs and they're fabulous. Roger Waters. I will, Rod Stewart, some of the clips I've done that are really good. I sat there a while. Clips of Rod and clips of Roger. We'll put it out somewhere. I'll put it on my YouTube channel. We'll put it on somewhere so you can see it. But two fabulous nights, two really great concerts. Then, today, I'm asked by my buddy Scott Pierce to come out and play in the Knockboro golf outing. North Oakland County Board of Realtors had one heck of a great golf outing that my office used to win on a regular basis. And there was a lot more attendees back in the day. I don't know, we need to pump that event up. It's a charitable event. It's a great thing for North Oakland County and the Board of Realtors. We need to really push for getting that back in big status. We were at Pine Knobs Golf Course. Scott, thank you. Oh, well, and Whitney showing it. So I got up today, and I've been playing golf since I was 4 and 5. My dad taught me. I played in junior invitationals. I thought I was actually going to try and do it for a living for a while there. I had a 2 handicap. Not anymore. Relax. But I used to. And love golf. I came my closest at Silver Lake on the par 3 there, number 8. Hit right behind the hole. It's drifting right back, right to the hole. We thought it moved around the cup years ago. I don't know why I woke up today and I said, I'm feeling really good. I'm going to concentrate and I'm going to have my first hole in one today. I'm going to. I can. Thank you, Lord, that the heavens were opening up. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it today. Look at this shot. It's inside my, it's like 4.5 inches away, a tap in. That much? Seriously? So I gave it a try, and we had a great time. Scott, I want to thank him and Don, and Rob was there. Both those guys from Wells Fargo, great job. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Scott, we're going to do a lot more fun things. We're going to do a lot more fun things. He's a great guy. We need mortgage help. Scott, you're going to be a busy guy. I'm going to turn you on to as many folks as I can. Thank you, pal. And Don, thanks for the golf outing. Waterford Hill. That's right. We're going to run out there tomorrow and do some interviews. And then Diana's going to tape. Diana Whitney, you're going out on Saturday. It's the vintage car race. And that's a really good time at Waterford Hill. Now, if you don't know where Waterford Hill is, start asking around. Check online. Waterford Hill race course. Right there, if you know where the Waterford Sportsman's is, and that's Waterford Road, if you go back there, I know it's a dirt road for a little bit, but the log cabins and all that on the side, back behind there is literally a road racing course. This is the road racing course. I've spent many a time. My ex-brother-in-law, Randy Tolliver, used to race out there. Sammy Voidenhoff, he taught out there and raced out there, and sometimes I think still does. The vintage race is great because it's the older cars, it's guys who've been there. Heck, Dick Purtis turned me up. His son, Ralph, and I went to school together. We went out to watch his dad race the first time I went out there. The body of his car flew off. I was telling Whitney this story. It really happened. But he's still driving. He was fine. Ralph thought his dad was decapitated or something. No. And Dick kept riding around. Dick, the owner of Overtime. Nice to say hi to Dick and shout out to him. With that, I know it's that time, folks, and I've got to hurry a little because we got to meet you at bingo. It's time to hear from the man himself. Hey, Jack, what's going on with the auto heads? Come on.
Well, it looks like another nice weekend coming up. We've got a lot of stuff going on. August 12th, the second annual Roadkill Night, powered by Dodge M1 Concourse. That's over on South Boulevard in Pontiac, Michigan. Actually, no, it's 11 till 11. Registration and ticket information, go to roadkill.com. That's right off of Woodward. They're doing it this year on Saturday. Unlike last year, they had it on Friday, and it really messed up everything. August 12th, downtown Main Street Charity Car Show, Main Street between Normandy and 14 Mile in Clawson, 8 to 6, unitedstreetmachines.com. August 12th, Corvette American All Corvette Show, Bowman Auto Center, 9603 Dixie Highway, Clarkston, Michigan. Rockin' Rods, Rochester Dream Cruise Warm-Up on Walton Boulevard, downtown Rochester, 9 to 4. Hey, there are 23 car shows between 11, 12, and 13th of August. A lot of shows going on, and a lot of them are all over the place. And Geno's on August 14th in Kego Harbor. That's on Cass and Orchard Lake at 5 p.m. Say, we went up to New Lothrop. I haven't been there in 20 years. It's a little town just off M13. It's not too far from Chesning and Montrose on 57. The original Flaming Pistons clubhouse was only 10 miles from this. We used to go over there quite a bit and do the earlier car shows. These little town car shows are great. They had pretty close to 200 cars. A lot of entertainment, a lot of things going on. They gave away a lot of nice gifts. They had 50 plaques for car winners, plus the best of show. You know, I tell everybody, get out and visit some of these little small towns. These communities put these shows on, like this one's been going on for 28 years. This auto events calendar has a lot of those around the Saginaw Valley, and like Owosso, Chesning, Clio, Montrose, Millington, Bertrand, they're not in the Cruisin' News. So I always tell everybody, start out the first of the year, I'll get this phone number on out to you guys. I can do it right now. We'll put it on the bottom down here. It's 517-945-4480. It's Auto Events Calendar. It's great. They've been doing it for 25 years. And you can get things put in there for free. Don't cost you anything. So we'll put this down across here so you can see it. Hey, again, small town, community, beautiful. Police department, as I'm pulling out, he waves at me and says, thanks for coming. That's not Royal Oak. Hey, we'll see you under the checkered flag.
Jack's always got a lot of information, folks, so you got to be ready for our times with Jack. There are a lot of great shows, and we've got the Woodward Dream Cruise coming, so be sure and support all those. There's a lot of fun. Last week we talked about no one could find our friend Bert from Bingo. He was the cook at the Bingo Hall right there at the old Heaven Lounge that we're heading to immediately after this. I know if you guys are watching live, Whitney and I are on our way. I know I'm running on a little bit. Jack went long. Wanted to say Bert was found. And hopefully he's in a better place. We'll miss you, Bert. So many friends and things have gone in the past, and I miss JH every day. If you watch Jeff Decker's Airs It Out, and you see Jim Wilhelm, myself, and Jeff Harris, JH, passed a few years ago, one of my best friends. And losing your friends, and it's tough. And I had a bit of a tough ride recently with what I'm doing in life and how things are going to go. And thank God for my friends and my daughter, Alex, to get me out of my funk. That's Debbie Wilhelm, Jim Wilhelm behind her, Remington, Tolliver, and Desiree next to me, their family and friends. This is the kind of thing that gets you out of your funk. And I want everybody to know that there are people out there to talk to. And I was reaching my limit a little bit there. It wasn't a good thing. And thank God for my daughter, Alex, to pump me up, talk me up, and let's get it going, Dad. This world can be a tough spot, and there are a lot of tough times in it, with family, with friends, with support from other people. I'm sorry that Bert didn't feel that we were all of that to him, but I think there were some other underlining issues. But we were there, and people are there for you, for me, for all of us. Grab those friends and don't let them go. Scott, you today. Just that great golf outing and a great time. Man, I've got a caddy for life in you, pal. And that shot that's just about went in, he clubbed me. You got to have a good caddy. Got to have a good support crew with you. Donna, the Tuesday night thing. Cork Bateman at Roger Waters. Whitney for supporting and putting up with me. And I know she's mad as heck for me right now and making us late for Bingo. But Whitney, I love you. You do so many great things for me. And I couldn't be more happy with all the stuff that you do. Thanks for everyone for watching this, for putting up with me. If you've got ideas and thoughts, same comment. I'm here for you. Thanks for watching.